Yo, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Hey, before we get started, I just want to remind everybody that I am sponsored by Astro Gaming. If you're looking for a new headset, in-ear monitors, or anything else to complement your gaming setup, visit astrogaming.com. Link in the description below. Code Prestige at checkout will get you a discount. Hey, guys, I want to talk a little bit more about the Ricochet anti-cheat, because within the past 24 hours, there have been quite a few videos released, not only by legitimate streamers, content creators, and players that have come across cheaters, but videos that have been uploaded from the cheaters' perspective, those that are actually using aimbots and showing what happens when Ricochet detects them. If you missed my video from yesterday, I highly recommend checking it out. I'll put a link in the description below. But just a small recap, we got a progress report from the Ricochet anti-cheat team. They let us know, apart from doing that banning process that they've been doing over the past few months now, they've also added additional data collection and mitigation techniques. These techniques are not used after the fact the game is over and you've already been wrecked by a cheater. They're actually utilized in-game, on the fly, in the live environment, in that very millisecond an engagement starts to begin. We learned about one of these mitigations yesterday called the damage shield. There's a clip from Tim the Tapman that I'll be playing on the screen right now. But basically what this does is, if a cheater is using an aimbot and they're shooting at you, a legitimate player, you as the legitimate player will gain God mode. They will never be able to kill you no matter how many times they shoot you. It doesn't matter. They can shoot you 10,000 times. You will never, ever die. And this gives you the opportunity to literally do whatever you want to them. You could walk up and execute them. You could punch them between the face. You could go continuously teabag in front of them as much as you want and then take them out with a 360 no-scope. It's up to you. They're at your will. They will not be able to take you out. So the good news is that damage shield is officially live through Ricochet, so all legitimate players should have a way better fighting chance against someone who's using an aimbot. But that was the only mitigation that was told to us yesterday. Now there's a new one that's been found. And of course, if you saw the title of this video, then you kind of already know where we're going with this. But on top of having that damage shield, legitimate players are now gaining legitimate invisibility. You turn invisible. If someone's using an aimbot, you turn invisible and it breaks the aimbot. And it makes it to where they can't actually track you anymore, which means if they can't see you and they can't track you and you're standing right in front of them, you could literally move left and right. They would never be able to kill you, and they can't kill you anyway because you have the damage shield on top of it. So even if they were able to shoot you and see you, the damage shield would mitigate it. But then on top of that, you're turning invisible. So you're going to be invisible, have God mode, and be able to do whatever you want to the person that's cheating. The reason we know about this is because there are people uploading videos of themselves using aimbots and wall hacks in Warzone and showing what happens when Ricochet detects them, because players are turning invisible as soon as they shoot the first shot. And that means, well, they can't track them, they can't take them out, and they wouldn't be able to do that anyway because of the damage shield that gives legitimate players God mode. So it's kind of incredible to see all of this working together, and I wonder how long it's going to last, because just like the Ricochet team mentioned in their blog post yesterday, it's always like a big game of tug of war. These cheat developers are always going to try to find a way to work around the barriers put in place by the Ricochet team, and it's always going to be that way. But the Ricochet team needs to continuously build up their barriers. And what we know about Ricochet as a program is that it continuously learns and evolves with machine learning in the live environment. It collects data as things are happening on the fly. Instead of just instantly booting people out and banning them, they're actively trying to learn what types of things that they're using to try and combat it even further. And by allowing legitimate players to continuously engage with these players, that's more and more time that the machine gets to learn about what types of cheats they're using in that exact moment. It truly does make me wonder what exactly is going to happen with the Ricochet system as it moves forward, as it learns, as we move into a next generation of Modern Warfare, as we move into probably another Black Ops game way in the future. But alongside banning, IP banning, permanent banning from multiple titles because the policy and security enforcement was updated, now we have actual in-game live environment protection from those who are trying to give everyone a bad time. So for the second half of this video, I want to talk about the dark side of Ricochet, something that was brought up in my comment section yesterday that I honestly didn't even consider. But y'all remember back in 2019, the end of 2018, it was a huge conversation that pretty much everyone talked about because we thought it was a patent for a system to change the way that the game is played with skill-based matchmaking, a skill-based matchmaking patent of sorts. And really, we all kind of came to the conclusion that it'd be used for PvE, to train AI, to make things a little more difficult or easier depending on the skill you were in the game. And now I'm actually starting to believe, like many of you, that that patent was actually for Ricochet. Because at the time, we didn't even know they were working on an anti-cheat. At the time, we didn't know Warzone was going to turn into what it is today. But they probably had a sneaking suspicion at that point that they'd need to do something quickly. And getting a patent for something like Ricochet, machine learning on the fly, in-game, with a live environment, it kind of goes hand in hand with each other. So that's probably what that ended up being. But someone mentioned in my comments section yesterday that what if Ricochet is used for bad? Now, I definitely need to preface this before we go any further. This is definite tinfoil hat conversation, but something that is honestly pretty scary to think about. If there was skill-based matchmaking utilized through Ricochet in regular multiplayer and, of course, Warzone, could they potentially use the things that we're seeing now, like invisibility and combat armor, to change the statistics for legitimate players only? So say we have two legitimate players, one an extremely high skill level, one a noob. Just like how Ricochet detects cheaters right now, could Ricochet detect a highly skilled player versus a noob in that moment and give the noob any type of advantage, whether that's stronger aim assist, maybe one bullet additional health. Maybe in that moment it can make the noob's gun a little bit stronger, allowing for a two-shot kill, or change the perspective of where the bullet hit. That way, instead of getting a headshot multiplier for hitting them in the head, they got a headshot multiplier for hitting them in the gut. You know, this is all types of different things that have been commented since that video came out yesterday, and I honestly didn't even think about that. I didn't think that anything like that would be used for bad, because right now it just seems like a really, really good thing. Now, like I said earlier, definite tinfoil hat conversation, definitely something that could potentially happen. In my heart of hearts, in my personal opinion, I don't think that they would ever, ever, ever do something like that. The team at Treyarch, Sledgehammer, Raven, Infinity Ward, they spend so much nut-crushing time trying to make sure that the game is as balanced as possible. It's not like the Modern Warfare 2 days where you have just one weapon that's just completely overpowered and it never gets touched the entire year. Every single weapon seems to be tweaked in some way, shape, or form in some capacity at some point. Buffed, nerfed, whatever. It's been that way for a very long time now. It's not like it was back in the MW2 days, but the point I'm trying to make is I just don't really see them going all out and doing that and adding another piece of workload to their already busy development cycle. So I personally don't think that's going to happen. I hope it doesn't happen. And if it does, well, of course, I'll have a follow-up video here, you know, years from now, if it ever does get discovered that that's what happens. But I really don't see them doing that. I really feel like Ricochet was built mainly for Warzone. Of course, it's going to have an effect in both multiplayer and Warzone, but it mainly seems like a thing for Warzone at this point. And that's pretty much all I got to say about it. Let me know what y'all think about it in the comments section below. Activision is giving invisibility to legitimate players to fight cheaters. That is insane. I really wonder what's going to be found next. What type of mitigation techniques will be discovered next? Thank you guys so much for watching this video today. If you enjoyed, drop a like. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. All right, folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.